Alright guys, so in the previous videos, we had seen about what is called the directed graph and few terminologies. And we had seen how we can use NetworkX package to work with directed graphs. So now in this lecture, we'll get started with what is the points distribution method, as the title says, what that actually is and what are we going to do. So for this example, let us take the same graph, the same very simple graph with just three nodes for demonstration purposes. And while programming, maybe we'll take a complex network as well. We can do that. Also, we'll take a very simple graph for demonstration purpose. Just this graph having three nodes, we'll be taking this for demonstration. And while programming, we can have a complex network as well. We can take that as an example. So let's get started. So before starting, I would just ask you to assume that this is a network of a social network, as you can say, of people liking each other. So you can consider this as probably I have collected a data about your family and friends. So these are your family members or friends. The nodes are the people, and this person likes this person. The person A likes person B. In that case, we'll have a directed edge from A to B. This is how the network has been constructed. If you would assume this way, it would be easier for you if I explain the points distribution method. So assume that this is our network, a simple network having just three nodes. Just assume the network is there is an edge between two people. If person A likes person B, there is a directed edge from person A to B. So for demonstration purpose, we'll be taking this simple network containing just three nodes. While we are actually programming, we can construct a complex network as well, having many nodes and edges. You can construct any network and you can run your algorithm on it. For demonstration purpose, we'll take a very simple network. So just assume that these nodes are people and there is a directed edge from person A to person B if person A likes person B. So something like that. So we'll get started with the points distribution method. Okay. So initially, all the nodes are given equal points. So points, you can also consider it as some gift items or gold coins, anything. Some item is given to all the three people. Something equally has been given. And they have been asked to play a sort of a game, something like that. The rule of this game is whatever you are having, you should share it equally with all your out edges. So we had collected the data of who all you like, right? So out edges, who all this person A likes person B and person C. Person B likes just person C. Person C just likes person A. So this is the data, right? So you're supposed to share whatever you have equally with all you like. So that is the rule. So they have to play the game. So initially they have equal number of points. But due to this exchange of the points, the next iteration, the points may not be equal to all the three. But one thing is guaranteed is the sum of points will be the same. Initially, let us say we have given some x points to each person. So 3x is the sum, right? So the same 3x, the sum of 3x would be maintained throughout. But the individual values each person is having will differ. So let us see. Let us see node A. Node A has got two neighbors. By neighbors, I mean those people to whom there is an outward edge. That is, person A likes these two people, person B and C. So these are the neighbors. So given that there are two people, you should divide it into 1 by 2. Since there are two people, that's why it's 1 by 2. If there are three people, it will be 1 by 3. If there are k people, it will be 1 by k. You should partition your total points into that many fragments and you should be giving it to all those people. That is the rule for node A. Let us see for node B. Whoever he is having, he should give it entirely to node C. 1 by 1, it's 1. So he should give it entirely to node C. And node C, if you consider, he just has one neighbor. He just likes one person, node A. So whatever he's having, he should give it entirely to node A. So I guess, do you sense something that we have started with equal points each, but even after just one exchange in this fashion, obeying this rule, there is more points will be acquired by node C, given that node A will also give something to him, node B will also give something to him. Given that two people are giving, he'll acquire more. Something like that. One node will acquire more and one node will acquire less, but the sum of the points will be the same. That is, if you add up the points with A, B and C, initially whatever was the sum, we started with equal number of points, let us say x points to node A, node B, node C. The sum is the addition of all these three values is 3x. The same 3x would be maintained even after this iteration. Like this, you have to repeat this process for multiple number of times. So this is how you have to give. So a node is giving to someone as well as getting from someone, right? So we'll see the getting details now. So node A will get something. So that will be his new points. Initially, they were given equal number of points. Let us say 100 points for simplicity. They were given 100 points each. Node A 100, node B had got 100, node C has got 100. So 300 points total in the system. So each node has 100 points initially. So following that rule, they had to share their points along with their neighbors. So the node will have to give it to its neighbors as well as it will get some points from someone who likes him. So for example, let's say node B, he likes node C. So he would give his points to node C as well as node A likes node B, right? So he will also give. So node B will be getting something as well. So each node will be giving something as well as getting something. So we'll see what it gets. That's what I mean by new points. Initially, everything was equal. Following this exchange rule, they had exchanged their points. And what is the new points? Node A will get everything from node C, right? So whatever was the old points of C, that will entirely come to A. That is the new points. And for node D, he'll get half from A because A likes B and C. So he has to, as per the rule, he has to share it equally with both the people, right? So he'll get half of it. So do you see that? Initially there was 100 points. Now given that he's getting just half of it, now B will be settled with 50 points. After this one exchange, same like that for node C, the new points is he'll get half from node A as well as from B entirely he'll be getting. So this is how the game has to be played, a game where initially all the nodes were given equal points, say 100 points, and the points has to be exchanged between the parties following this rule that how many ever outgoing edges you have and how many ever points you have, you should share it equally among all the people. So that is the rule. Following that, you should play the game. So if you keep playing this game, if you keep doing it, so after one iteration, as I have said, this we can say it's iteration, one exchange, one round. After one round, as we had said, node A had some 100 points, node B had some 50 points as you could see, and node C will be having 150 points. Straightforward math, you can work out and you will get to know that. So this is the status after one exchange. Now with this state, they are again following the same rule, and node A had 100 points, right? So he'll divide into 50-50, node B had 50, he'll give that 50 entirely. They follow the same rule and they'll play this. What happens? If you play this for say some 1000 iterations or 10,000 iterations, if you keep doing it, what happens? Let us see that in the next part.